Thank you, Jared. And tonight we're learning more about the safety measures that helped keep yesterday's fire at the pumps from spreading even further. Eyewitness News reporter Madeline Wright continues our in-depth coverage.
Without those safety measures, the gas station could have exploded. The pumps at the Sunoco gas station are covered in white film. It's a fire suppression powder that helped keep this fiery crash Tuesday from blowing up the gas station.
When there's a fire, it has sensors on the canopy outside. So once there's a fire out there, it triggers the sensors and the suppression system goes off. So it helps big time to keep the fire down.
The owner of the gas station just got his suppression system inspected last month. The heat from the fire triggered these nozzles in the canopy to release the chemical, keeping the fire from spreading.
Everything checked out. And basically, that was my main goal today, to find out if it did go off right on time, and it did.
Another thing that went off on time, the check valve system. These valves underneath every pump shut off when the fiery crash happened, keeping gasoline from spilling. The owner of the gas station also manually stopped gas from flowing to the pumps.
There's a state law that you have all your employees trained, you know, and they should know in case of emergency how to shut everything down.
Good Samaritans helped put the flames out using fire extinguishers placed at the pump. The gas pump inspector credits the woman who parked her SUV at the pump.
Her car actually stopped it from getting more serious because, from what I understand, the way the accident went, if that car wasn't there, it would have went into the building.
The owner of the gas station also credits the fire department for their quick response. As for when his gas pumps can reopen, it could be weeks, even months. Madeline Wright, Eyewitness News.